Hello friends, welcome to YouTube channel CrackGate Online. In this video, I will deal with most important topic of hydrology, that is hydrograph. So before starting, please make sure when you are subscribing this channel, you have this bell icon as on. Then only you will get all the notifications whatever video we are uploading. So this is about me. You can read about me here. So I will deal with in this video about hydrograph, unit hydrograph, flood and the S hydrograph. So let me make it clear that I am here not dealing with your semester syllabus, rather I am giving you the approach how to solve question related with hydrograph. So in this 3 or 4 video, I will make sure that you can solve the questions which are coming from this topic. So rest theory you can read from any book, and if you have any doubt in any topic, then you can comment. So after watching this video, I hope you will be able to solve the numerical part of hydrograph. So if anybody asks you what is hydrograph, then simply you can tell hydrograph is the graphical representation of discharge versus time. So any typical hydrograph will look like this. So this has 3 components. One is the rising limb. This is rising limb. This is the peak point and this is the recession limb. So this rising limb will depend on area as well as the rainfall parameter, known as the climatic parameter, while recession limb will only depend on the aerial parameter. Why? Because initially rainfall happens and this portion is affected by both rainfall as well as area characteristic. Aerial characteristic means type of soil, infiltration capacity, like this. But here rainfall has stopped, so this is the only area which is affecting this portion of the hydrograph. So this they can ask in objective type of question, so you please remember. And this is the peak of hydrograph. So before going into the main hydrograph area, you please understand this. I have explained in already the 5 next video. Before watching, you please watch that video also. And you tell me in the comment section what is difference between precipitation and rainfall. Okay, so suppose rainfall is happening, then what will happen? Certain water will infiltrate into the soil, and those water will again go deeper into the soil. That is known as the percolation, and that percolation will further go deep and will join with the groundwater. And that groundwater will eventually merge with the any water body or any stream. So this groundwater, this portion of rainfall is known as the base flow. Please remember this. And the water which is flowing on the upper strata of the soil and meeting the stream, same stream, it is known as the through flow. And the water which is flowing over the surface, that is known as the runoff or the surface runoff. So in hydrograph, we are more concerned about these 2 parts. Okay. So if you want to represent this all thing in a graph, that is known as the hydrograph. So here you can see how we have represented those things into the graph. So whatever water that was going into the stream with deep percolation, that is known as the base flow. And these 2, the overland flow and the through flow, it is constitute the part of direct runoff. So here if you can see, the overland flow plus through flow equal to strong flow or the direct runoff flow, or in this you will call as the direct runoff hydrograph. Okay, and this I have already explained. And you can remember this term, the peak of rainfall to the peak of hydrograph, it is known as the basin lag time. The formula for this I will show in later part. And you please tell me what is isochrome in the comment section. And please remember all these definitions, because they can ask you objective type of question. What is this isochrome, isobar, isocline, and many isos like definitions are there. So you please remember those. So I hope the basic of hydrograph is clear. So now these are the 2 most important formula you have to remember. And what is the unit hydrograph, I will explain in upcoming slide. But for now, you remember if you want to calculate the ordinate, ordinate is nothing but the y-axis, and y-axis of a hydrograph is nothing but the discharge. So discharge of unit hydrograph is equal to discharge of direct runoff hydrograph divided by effective rainfall. And how you will calculate direct runoff? Direct runoff by hydrograph minus base flow. And what is base flow? I already explained what is base flow. So base flow data will be given in question. So see, this is the observed hydrograph. When you will reduce the base flow, so this graph will come down definitely. This is DRS. And when you will divide this DRS divided by effective rainfall, then you will know the unit hydrograph. Okay, so you please remember these two formulas. So there is nothing much in this slide, you can pause and read, but you please remember unit hydrography, unit centimeter of rainfall for d hour duration. Unit centimeter means 1 centimeter of rainfall in d hour. This d can be either 1 hour, 2 hour, 3 hour or any hour. Means in unit hydrograph your depth will remain same as 1 centimeter, but this effective rainfall, and please remember this is effective rainfall, means total amount is getting converted into the surface runoff, no water is going into inside the soil. So this is effective rainfall. So this effective rainfall can be done in 1 hour or 2 hours. So this d will change while this 1 centimeter will remain same. So this will get clearer with one example. So let's do this example and you will get more confident. Okay, so now I think basic is clear. So here what they are, you first need to understand the approach. Okay, so please see the approach. So they are saying obtain the unit hydrograph. What you know about unit hydrograph? So for unit hydrograph, first you need to calculate the DRH, okay, and then you need to calculate the effective rainfall. Then only you can calculate the ordinate of unit hydrograph. So see, this 100, 100, everywhere 100 is there. So this you need to consider as base flow. So what I showed you, in hydrograph, when you will reduce base flow, you will get the DRH, okay. So from each and every data, you first calculate DRS for all these. Then you add this DRS. Now what you need, you have area. If you will divide the volume by area, then you will get the effective rainfall. Means from DRS, you are getting effective rainfall. Why? Because the direct runoff is directly flowing over the surface, and that surface water is coming from the effective rainfall only. Okay, so this effective rainfall, how you can calculate? So first you calculated DRS. So here this 200 gone because of base flow. This 300 minus 100 equal to 200. So all this you add into what is delta H? Delta H is 1 hour. So 3600. Now you get the volume. So how to calculate depth? Divided by area. So area has been given 315. So you get the effective rainfall. Now you have the all the data for DRH, you have all the data for, you have effective rainfall. Now simply you can calculate the unit hydrograph. So here they have used the same formula. You divide this by 4, all this data divided by 4. So ordinate of unit hydrograph is ordinate of DRH divided by effective rainfall. So now you get the unit hydrograph. What I told you, that this is for per centimeter, okay, but you don't know what is the d hour duration. I told you unit centimeter of rainfall can be any hour duration. So how to calculate this d? I will say this unit hydrograph is for how much hour time. So to calculate this, you can see this graph here also. It will this is same graph what I showed you earlier. So now to calculate the time, the d hour, the rainfall data has been given. So how, so in this rainfall you need to know this d is effective d. Effective time means whatever amount of rainfall is actually contributing into the surface runoff. Okay, so how I will know? For this, I need to calculate the fine depth. And what is my fine depth? Fine depth is rainfall. So what is rainfall? You sum all these. So it is 5 plus 1, that is 6, minus rainfall minus runoff. What is runoff? I calculated. Runoff is 4 cm. From previous data, we calculated 4 divided by total time. So it will come as 0.5 cm per hour. So what is meaning of fine depth? So this much water is getting lost per hour. So it will contribute to the runoff? No, because this much water will directly go into the soil. So this is not contributing. This is also not contributing. So what is contributing? This 1 to 2 hour and 2 to 3 hour. So here you can see. So these are the two durations which is contributing into the surface runoff. So what I can say, this T is 2 hour. Okay. So whatever unit hydrograph I calculated, it is for 2 hour duration. So I can say the T is equal to 2 hour unit hydrograph, and my ordinates are, I have calculated here. So these are my coordinates. So one more concept quickly we can see. This is the flood hydrograph. Flood hydrograph is nothing but the same simple hydrograph. Means here it is not the DRH. This is the key point you have to remember. Means from flood hydrograph you want to calculate direct runoff, then you have to remove what? You have to remove the base flow. Okay, so base flow you have to remove from flood hydrograph. And you flood hydrograph you need to calculate like discharge from a particular lever over a given period of time. So this flood hydrograph are used to calculate, to manage the flood data from a particular river, so that based on this data you can design your flow devices such as the orifice or notches. Okay, so this is the same graph will be valid for flood hydrograph. From here you need to reduce the base flow. So all other formula and everything is same. So you just need to remember the flood hydrograph is a simple hydrograph. You need to it is not the direct runoff hydrograph. So they can as in objective type of question. So in this video what we understood, what is hydrograph, what is direct runoff hydrograph, what is unit hydrograph, and how to calculate DRH from hydrograph, and how to calculate unit hydrograph from the DRH, how to calculate the effective rainfall, and what is the flood hydrograph. So this much theoretical with one example we saw. In the next video, I will take the all previous year questions which are coming from this topic, and one more I will take the triangular hydrograph in the next video, and after that I will take the S curve. Okay, so these 3 or 4 video I will cover entire numerical part which is coming from the hydrograph, and each and every year at least you will get one question from hydrograph or fine depth. So fine depth video I have already explained. So please do watch that video. And if you have any query regarding this video, then please do comment. So thank you for watching this video. Please do like, share and subscribe the channel. Have a nice day. Thank you.